cup of coffee.
It's all good. It's Q101.1, Ryan Manno at the 51st Annual Grammy Awards Staples Center in Los Angeles with Phil Keoghan, host of The Amazing Race. I cannot believe that you're heading into your 14th. Is it 14 or 15? 14. 14th season?
Yeah.
Can you believe it?
No. I can't. I can't. I remember when we did season one, we did the first episode of season one, and I thought, if we make it back alive and we actually get around and finish one season, it'll be a miracle, it'll be a life-changing experience, and it'll be enough to have said that we did this race around the world.
Yes.
So to be talking about 14, it's so beyond comprehension right now. No, I'd never, ever thought we would be talking about Amazing Race 14.
What about the challenge to stay, you know, to stay fresh and to stay new? Because I know, you know, Survivor pulls out, you know, they pull out, you know, all these different tricks and tips and stuff. I mean, or not, they pull out, you know, they try to just change things up a lot. But I mean, talk about staying relevant.
Well, I think our show has a major advantage over most reality shows, and that is that when we shoot the series, we don't go back to the same locations ever.
Right.
So if you know, shows that are studio based that have the same set, they go back to the same set. They change the people, but the set is the same.
Sure.
And most reality shows are going back to a similar location. Our show never goes back to anything remotely like anything else. You know, this season we're heading off to Siberia and Romania. We've never been to Siberia. I mean, the place is... It was unbelievable going there.
Yeah.
Totally unique from anything we've done in 14 seasons. The great thing about our stage, if you like, where we race, is that we've got literally the world to choose from.
Yeah.
So we can keep it fresh. And when you put the new faces on that, then that's how I think we have an advantage in terms of longevity, in terms of keeping the show going. Because audiences say to, you know, fans say to me, we love the race. We love the teams that you have on. And we love going to those places because we feel like we're going there with you.
Yeah.
So I think that's a huge hook. I think as much as they love the teams,
yep.
I think they love the places as much too.
Yeah, it's like hearing you say that, it's inherent in the show to stay fresh, to be fresh. It's just fresh by nature.
And then this season, we've freshened up all the graphics, we've freshened up the music, we've freshened up all the maps and everything. You know, it was time. We haven't wanted to reinvent anything with our show because it's been working. It's you know, struck a chord with people. But we did want to sort of do a little spring cleaning with the music and the graphics.
Sure.
And we have, I believe, this season, one of the most dynamic casts that we've had since season 7. I had the same feeling after shooting season 7 that I've got now after shooting season 14. We've always had good casts,
mm-hmm.
but there was something very special about season 7, season 5, season 3, season 1. And the other shows, you know, the other seasons, I think we've maintained a great standard, but there's something really unique about this mix in season 14.
Has there been a point, I don't know anything about Siberia, has there been a point where wherever you've gone that you felt unsafe or thought, I might die today, or scared?
Well, no, I mean, apprehensive, absolutely. I mean, I went to Ukraine once, and I got held up in immigration, and everybody went through except for me, because I was traveling with a New Zealand passport, and they said I didn't have the right documentation, and they put me in a room overnight, and all the teams were racing ahead on the race course, and I was meant to be at the pit stop. We estimated that I was meant to be there at about 10 o'clock in the morning, and at 3 o'clock in the morning, I was lying on a plastic bench, and it was about, it was about 58 degrees, and nobody spoke any English, and what saved me was that the woman from the American consulate in Ukraine was a huge Amazing Race fan.
Oh my God, perfect.
She stayed up all night to get me out of there, and I literally ran out of immigration, got in a car, went straight to the pit stop, and this is no exaggeration. I got out of the car and I saw about a half a mile away the first team running in.
Yeah.
I ran to the mat, stood there, said a quick hello to the greeter. Hey, how you doing? He said, I'm good. I said, great. And then the team like ran in 20 seconds later.
Amazing.
Boom, we just went straight into your team number one. And then I was like,
perfect.
Into the interview.
That's hilarious. That's awesome.
Yeah.
I'm sure you get asked this all the time, but what's your favorite? What if you had to pick a favorite? Can you pick a favorite place on Earth?
Well, I'm originally from New Zealand. I love New Zealand. I love Italy because I love the people. I think places countries are all about the people.
Sure.
And some countries, you know, countries have a lot to offer. I live in America because I love America. Presumably I live in America because I think it has the best opportunity. But I think it's great that on a show like Race, we can also share other amazing cultures. And when you think about it, America is really a piece of everything else in the world.
Yeah.
I mean, all cultures have come here. So to me, United States of America, it represents, it has a global feel. And I think lots of people reach in to come into America. What I would love to see is more Americans reach out to look at the rest of the world. And I think Amazing Race helps people do that.
Yeah. You're doing good work, man. It's great. It's great to see you, for real. I love the show, and I'm happy for you.
You're hooked on it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
It is amazing.
Amazing.